called out my name.
Through my past,
covered my shame. Such amazing grace you shown, so patiently you shown, so patiently, and you waited for me, just for me.
You waited, come on.
Oh, where would I be if you left me now? Where would I be if you left me? I don't wanna know. I don't wanna know. I don't wanna know. I don't wanna know. You wait. Yeah. Hallelujah. Where would I be if you left me now? Where would I be if you left me? I don't wanna know. I don't wanna know. I don't wanna know. You waited. Waited. You waited. Waited. And I'm shocked. And I'm shocked. Waiting, waiting. Where would I be? Where would I go? Where would I be? Where would I go? You waited. You waited. You waited. You waited. Erabusha. The Bible declares that term. Stand still and wait on the Lord. God told Joshua to tell the Israelites, today you will see the salvation of your God, to stand still. They had in front of them the Red Sea. They had no boats. They couldn't swim like that. They had possessions. And behind them, they had the charge of the chariots of Pharaoh. They were in a hard place. Well, God declares that he'll do a hard thing for you. You must understand here that the songwriter says God waited for him. You got to look at what he's saying and what the scripture teaches. It's nothing wrong with believing and get God waiting for you to change your mind. That's not actually how the God that I serve operates. What happened was that at the right time, at the right moment, in God's divine plan for your life, he revealed himself to you. So in all actuality, you waited on God. You don't know how God moves, even when you think you know him. I want you to understand that God, you never know how he's coming, but he's coming. Hey, the Bible says that, wait a minute, at the Feast of the Leavens, at the feast, they were looking for Jesus to kill him. And the Bible teaches that Jesus told two of his disciples to go into town and you will see a white coat tied up there, a jackass, a donkey. And if it, untie him. And if anybody asks you what you're doing, you tell them the master needs him. And somebody asked them what you're doing. They said the master needs him, and they left him alone. Now, wait a minute. I said you don't know how he's coming. They're looking for him to kill him. This is an albino rare species of any kind. I've seen albino deers. Not deers, one deer. There was one that run with a pack. And he's white, I swear to God, he's white, funny looking. Albinos, huh? He come on that day, sitting, give me something here. I feel like teaching. He was sitting on the side of the donkey. He was saying, hey, coming in, and a white donkey. They said, the Bible said, they were throwing down palm leaves in front of him, taking off their coats and playing it down in front of him as he came into town. And they were shouting, oh, Hosanna, oh, Hosanna. Long live the king. You don't know how he's coming, but he's coming. He didn't come today the way he came yesterday. Amen. There is a time and a place that where God will meet you, but you have to do it regularly. But meeting you there is not what the bishop said. I didn't say he won't meet you. I said you don't know how he's coming. Well, let me help you. He says about himself, behold, I come quickly. I got a prophetic word from the Lord. I come before you all in the name of a prophet. I greet you all in Jesus' name. Let us pray. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth remain silent before him. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Eternal Father, oh, Hosanna, the God of many surprises. We say, Lord God, thank you for things and more things. Master, we thank you for the bad. We thank you for the good. Master, we thank you for what we see and for what we cannot see. We thank you for our existence. We thank you for being our God. We just want to say thank you. In retrospect, I want to say thank you for protecting and caring over me when I was in my debauchery, my drunken state. Amen. Lord God, I say thank you. Father God, I plead the blood of Jesus. Master, I plead the blood of Jesus. Master, I plead the blood of Jesus on Satan. I plead the blood of Jesus on Jezebel. I plead the blood of Jesus on Beelzebub. I plead the blood of Jesus on all demonic spirits from hell. Bind them. Ha. Cast them down back to hell from where they come from. I command them to get out of this ministry right now and stay out. In Jesus' name I pray. Now, Father God, strengthen my team. Strengthen the studio. Strengthen your prophet. And we all give you the glory in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, send your anointing. Father God, send your anointing. Father God, send your anointing. Master, send your word. Master, send your word. Master, send your word in Jesus' name. Now, Father God, all these things I asked in your name, the name above every name, the name of Jesus. Let the redeemed say amen, and it is so. Hallelujah. Saints of God, in the book of Peter, 1 Peter is where my text is coming from. I come to preach. I'm not talking to you, I'm serving the devil, notice. I come to preach. And when I begin to preach, I don't care where you are, rest on your feet and shake the devil off of you. Shake him off! He's the only one that's telling you not to praise God. The Bible makes it plain that victory is in your praise. The Bible makes it plain that God dwells in the midst of the people of praise. He told, help me, Holy Ghost. It wasn't Joshua, it's the other one, the other boy. He told him to send Judah before the battle. He said, hey, Joshua, I don't know. If it comes to me in the middle of the message, I'll tell you, the importance is I'm talking about praise. Judah, that's English. Judah in Hebrew is praise. He said, send Judah before the battle. He said, have the trumpet sound. Don't march, don't move. Have the trumpets to sound. Now, at the wall of Jericho, he told them to march around the fortified city one time for 7 days. One time. They looking at them, they think they stupid. They ain't got no weapons. They just marching, singing, praising. Listen to the prophet. And he said, on the seventh day, I want you to march around the city 7 times. And on the seventh time, stop and have the trumpets to sound. And watch the walls come tumbling down. Come on, somebody. And when the trumpets sound and the walls begin to delinquish their whole and fail, they fail as ramps so that the Israelites can walk up over into the fortified city. I come to preach. Yeah. In the book of Peter, chapter 1. Did you hear what I said? That's supernatural. They fail. Not blocking the entrance, covering up what they were going through, but it gave them a walkover. Somebody say, if God said it, I believe it. God say things that you don't believe. You know why? Because you don't know him. If he said something that you already knew, it ain't the God of the Bible. Because God said, I'll do a new thing. Amen. Watch this. In the book of 1 Peter, y'all pray for the bishop. Chapter 5. I'll pick it up at verse, where did I put down there? 1 and 2. Then we're going to jump down to somewhere and then jump down to 6, like 6 to 8. And again, I solicit your prayers in the book of 1 Peter. The elders which are among you, I exalt, who am also an elder, and I witness of the suffering of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Verse 2. Feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lure, but for a ready mind. A ready mind. The Lord told me many, many years ago, as he told Peter, he asked him, do you love me? Peter said, Lord, you know I love you. He said, well, then feed my sheep. Bible says that he went on and asked Peter again. He said, Peter, do you love me? And Peter said, Lord, you know I love you. Then God said, feed my lamb. He told me, he says, feed my sheep. Feed my lamb. Right here, text says, feed the flock of God that's amongst you. So they'll have a ready mind. A ready mind. That's my text. Come down here to verse 6, and it says, humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hands of God, that he may exalt you in due time. That word exalt means to raise up, to build up, to take you out of your debauchery, to take you out of your gory mess, to take you out of your dark season and raise you up. He exalts you. He said, I exalt the elders amongst you. Who? I myself am an elder. He says, I will exalt you in due time, in God's timing. God can't take you higher when you're still loving your low life. You see, God is not going to force a man to do anything. Ain't that ignorant? You don't believe what I just said. You think he forced me to do stuff. I know you do. Because I say, I don't want to preach. Because I said that. He didn't force me to do it. He caused calamity in my life that where I myself. If you want to know what was the breaking point, jailhouse. When he shut me down, set me down, locked me up, had me preach to every demonic spirit there is in the earth, was in that jailhouse. And I was successful preaching to him. Come out of there with a title, preacher man. he didn't make me do it. He caused things to happen and closed down everything else. There wasn't nothing else to do. I knew what he wanted. Huh? But there's one thing about this God. Everything that he commands a man to do, God will pay for it. Humble yourself under the mighty hands of God that he may exalt you in due season. Be sober. Be vigilant. Oh, wait a minute. 7. Cast all your care upon him, for he cares for you. He cares for you. Be sober. Be vigilant. Watch this. This is my text, man. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walk about seeking whom he may devour. Saints of God, my text for today is stay alert. Stay alert. Somebody say, preach, Bishop. Here we see here how Peter is giving advice about the enemy and his movement against the child of God. Knowing that the enemy is the opposer to the child of God, and that the enemy is already defeated. And we know that his time is short, but time and the enemy are not together. You see, the enemy is in a place where there is no time. Amen. Time is earthly. It's for the earth. There is no time in the spirit realm. I come to teach. That's why God can be everywhere at the same time. There's no restrictions. It's wide open space. He can be in my house in Nashville, Tennessee. He can be in your house in Chicago, Illinois at the same time, because there is no time. Time is for man. Time is for man to know what day it is and what time it is. It ain't for the spirit world. And so the devil doesn't operate on time. That's why he lurks and waits for you. Peter says he's roaming. That is a true text, because this is New Testament. Be alert. But God in the Old Testament asked him, where you been? Where you coming from? The Bible says when the sons of God came back to God, and it says Satan came with them. He asked him where he been. He said, roaming 2 and 4, the earth. You see, when he's in the earth here, he cannot be everywhere and every time. God stripped him from his ability to go into the spirit realm and his ability to be creative. So therefore, everything that you're still doing, God's already delivered you from it when he took them 39 stripes plus 1 at the whipping post. You're no longer addicted to crack pot or cocaine. You ain't no longer addicted to pornography. You're addicted to the idea that you can't stop. Well, you got to be alert, because God told me to make plain. He's up to something new. God says, I'm going to bring you out so I can bring you in. You see, God must bring you out of something before he can bring you into his glory. Hey, you know, be alert. In other words, not with much wine and drinking, not too much partying. Now, when the Bible says not much, it says that. It does not say forbid to drink it, because every man can take a toast at a celebration, at a wedding, at a birthday. You can do it in moderation. But when it becomes medical, yeah, when your body craves it, you got a problem. Amen. But be alert, because where God is, he's preparing to bring you there also. He made that plain through the minds of all of his disciples. He said, I will come back for you to receive you into myself. But you got to be alert, because the closer you get to victory, the harder it is to cross. Do you understand that I have ran and won a lot of road races, a whole lot of track victories? But on the track, it's not like on the road. On the track, I don't have what I'm getting ready to tell you. On the road is where I have it. I have broken races wide open. I have set course records. And I've come back the following year and broke that record, broke my own record, chasing my own record. Let me go where I'm going here. But the closer I would get to finishing, the harder it would get mentally. I'm wide open. I don't look behind me. I look at the crowd. If they looking behind me, somebody's coming. If they just looking at me, they'll tell you, you're looking good. You're looking good. Oh, bam. Now, I'm probably about 2 miles out. Them some of the hardest 2 miles to put together, because all the finished work is done. Now I got to button it up, which means I got to shut down any kind of thinking and let my training take me home, because it gets tough down in the stretch, because somehow, somewhere, you believe someone's coming. Someone's going to overtake you. You're going to have to fight to get in. But that is a thing that happens in the earth. When the Bible says about these many cloud of witnesses in Hebrews, we must understand that they understand that it's getting harder as we get older to come closer, because it's just the nature of man. That's why it's important that you must stand still and watch God's salvation in your life. You can't up the ante and push it any closer. You can't lay back. You got to be where you are, in a place to where God can use you. God has a plan and a purpose for every man, but you got to be alert. Somebody say, I'm stay alert, because I know the enemy wants me now, because I have surrendered my own thinking and picked up the true gospel, the one and only Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You got to stay alert, because what God is breaking you off in, you're close to a breakthrough right now, and your breakthrough is life-changing. You will never have to worry about what you're worrying about now. Somebody say, I'm no longer concerned about anything. I've got a mind to serve God. I've got a made-up mind to serve the Lord. Somebody shout, I'm ready. Stay alert. In the book of Ephesians, help me preach up. Preach. Chapter 1, verse 6, and it declares, hallelujah. Philippians. Paul says, being confident of this very thing, that he which has begun the good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Paul says, it ain't about you messing it up any longer. You can't mess up what God is getting ready to do. But Paul says he is confident of this one thing, that the one that started it It's going to complete. It's a saints of God, everything the Lord starts, he finishes. I ain't got time to play with you. He don't open up nothing and don't close it. I'm a preacher, amen. Everything God starts, he finishes. The apostle said he's going to bring it to completion until you see the Lord. He said, to the day of the Lord. When you see him, let me close. In Jesus' name, I feel that God is saying, stay alert because it's here. Your hour has come. Your time is all over you. But are you ready? I had my prophet preaching ever since he been in this arena, huh? To tell you, get ready, because God come quickly. And when he come, you ain't got time to get ready. You got to be ready. Am I right? You know that God said, get ready. Well, I'm looking here at the close. And I want you to know that stay alert means that there's something brewing. And that you know not of. God says, I'll raise up a prophet. And I send him from the east. A prophet that you know not of. And when I send my prophet, if he comes to you in the name of a prophet, then hearken to his prophecy. Hearken means surrender, listen, take hold of the words that the prophet speaks. In my close here, in the book of Isaiah, the eagle-eyed prophet, he says in chapter 54, am I right, Holy Ghost? Verse 17, that no weapons formed against you shall prosper. You better believe that's true, because I told you, you're being alert because there's weapons getting ready to come. The devil is shooting fiery arrows at you. He's shooting fiery darts at you. But the prophet says no weapons formed. That means made up, bought, stole, wherever they come from. No weapons against you shall prosper. And every word that spoke against you in judgment, my God shall condemn. Stay alert, stay alert, stay alert, stay alert. Because God has got a blessing with your name on it. And God says, now is your hour to break through. God says, I'm going to take you higher because I love you so well. I'm so glad about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God says, I'll speak to you. Hey! Nothing feels better than to know you. And nothing's more important than to show you. And nothing more fun than but the body. And nothing more fun than but the time spent with you. No one but you can love me too. How you love me when you love me and you tell me everything is gonna be alright. You mean no world to me. You are my everything, and I never, no, never, ever, ever want to know what it's not to know you. I want to wake up to you every day. Master, my. Abba. And you don't did against me that you don't really need me for nothing, that I need you for everything. So when I'm honest with you, telling you my issue, you get beneficial every time I kick it with you. And no games, no shame. Nah. Hallelujah. Stay alert. Your breakthrough is all over you. It's all over you. Ask for it. Ask for it.